All right, in a recent video, one that may even be linked in the description below, we asked the question and had some discussion around, could an AI chatbot replace your product owner? So let's look at this from the Scrum Master perspective. Could a AI replace your Scrum Master on your Scrum team? What do you think?
That's a fantastic question. We did a video a while back when ChatGPT was first kind of getting a lot of popularity. ChatGPT teach you Scrum? And I think we, at that time, figured it wasn't that great at teaching you Scrum.
No.
It had a lot of things wrong.
C plus at best.
C plus, yeah, we gave it a grade. It wasn't super good. However, I've checked recently and I've asked it some basic Scrum questions, and I was a lot more impressed with the answers. Still, a couple of weird words here and there, and maybe a couple of concepts not quite right, but it's gotten a lot better. Now, as a role of a teacher, could AI teach you Scrum? Yes. Theoretically, once it understands the rules and, you know, it's polished enough and it's been sort of shaped by the community. The question is, could AI stop you from what you're doing and say, hey, Robb, you know, look, you've been using the sprint review kind of wrong, and here, let me explain myself. No, AI is not going to do that. It's not going to interfere or get involved with what I'm doing unless I stop and say, hey, ChatGPT, am I doing this right? Or I have a question. And so it doesn't yet involve itself in your life. It just responds to questions and prompts. Right there, that's a big place where I'm like, I don't know where AI gets involved in actually sort of interrupting your life. It needs to be interrupted in order to get answers.
I've got a take on this. I'm going to use the Tesla example, at least for the moment. In the case of hyper automation and monitoring and transparency when it comes to the work, I think there's a significant amount of advantage that goes to the robots and to the AIs here, because they can watch everything, they can see everything. And it's just a matter of how much are you willing to spend on that. And if that's the case, then you don't really need a human to make the system more efficient, because you've got something that's doing all the monitoring for you. However, there's the human element again that the robot can't really help with. Like, it's not going to know if Jason and Greg are having it out and therefore causing an environment in which other engineers or other developers are kind of stressed and not feeling the love right now. And they're not going to come in and help with conflict resolution. At least, again, not anytime soon that I'm aware of. And
right.
And these same robots, even though they might be able to kind of police and monitor what's going on with the team, how do you deal with the overall organizational flood of impediments and blockades that can actually affect your flow of value? And so I just don't think it's reasonable. There's a good measure and a good part of that responsibility that I think AI could actually do better than a Scrum Master. But the pieces that really matter with the human components, it's going to fall flat big time.
Yeah.
Yeah, a big part of being a Scrum Master is people problems.
Yeah.
Yeah, exactly. A good Scrum Master can read the room and kind of like we said with the product owner, empathize with people and understand very nuanced, complex human behaviors and emotions. You know, unsurprisingly, perhaps, I also agree that an AI is not going to replace your Scrum Master. I'm going to come at it from a little different angle, though. In our Scrum Master training classes that all three of us teach, I'm thinking of a very particular graphic visual aid that we use, which is like this wheel of Scrum Master choices. And there's things on there like teaching and mentoring, like you were talking about, Robb. There's facilitation and coaching and some other things. Sometimes it's actively doing nothing and being aware of a problem and choosing not to intervene, because in your judgment, it's better to let the problem, the people that are involved in the problem, work through it and come with a solution themselves, rather than step in and say, oh, guys, there's a problem here, let me fix it for you, or let me, you know, make sure I facilitate. Sometimes it's better for a Scrum Master not to be involved and just be aware of something and let it play out, because the team may become stronger from working through a problem. So the nuanced decision making that has to happen, I don't think AI is anywhere near that. Even if it did have the sensors to monitor of what people were saying and how people were feeling and things like that. I still don't think the judgment that humans can exhibit, I don't think anywhere AI is anywhere near that. In 100 or 200 years, I'm not going to say what's possible, but right now, nowhere close. Hey, thanks for watching that video. Did you like what you heard? If so, you're going to love our Scrum classes. See, not only do we talk about these ideas on YouTube, we're also professional Scrum trainers, and we'd love to have you in one of our classes. So if you need to level up as a Scrum Master or a product owner, maybe you need to learn how to scale Scrum or combine Kanban or UX with Scrum, click the link in our description and you'll find a list of our upcoming classes.
If this is your first time to our channel and you're interested in growing in your agility and understanding things like Scrum and other agile topics, then be sure to get started by subscribing right now and hit that alert button. I don't want you to miss a thing.